Stand up. Oh, you are standing up? My bad.
Alex, that's not right. You know, just forget. Let's move on. First up, we have the Elite Choir. There's a total of 104 members, and they're all led under the direction of Mrs. Linda McNamara. Today, we will be singing Salvation is Created.
Yeah. scratch one in linoleum print. Suba Shamagawa, linoleum print. Matthew Eby, linoleum print. Allie Davis, art history temper paint style in the style of Jackson Pollock. Gina LaRubio, Renee Greiser, and Samantha Hall, all with colored pencil flowers on blackboard. Lisa Feller, colored pencil flowers on blackboard. Gina Brazier, surrealist collage, and Laura Kalsar, surrealist collage. For our group, Jay Miller, dry chrome etching with watercolor tint, Jamie Forbes with her ceramics piece, and Paul Steele Dryer with an linoleum print and six-part art history mixed media.
come, jitterbug, and start with the rock step. Replace the touch steps with skip steps. Now hop, not just pause, on each beat, and you have the jump swing style. It was created in Southern California by two dance instructors who watched teenagers jump around during the spring revival of the 1990s. Led by Big Bad Moon Daddy, Royal Crown Review, Brian Setzer, and others, they observed totally untrained students doing various improvised kicks, patterns, and wondered what kind of six-count groove could be made out of this natural response to music. The song you are about to hear was written in the 50s by Luke Prima, who actually inspired Elvis to do his swinging rockabilly style. The Brian Setzer Orchestra played this arrangement in 1998. Here's Jump, Jive, and Wail.
Remind me of that moment. One True Thing by Anna Quinlan. Okay, prosecuting case. Very tough, hard, wrong woman, gone crazy, gives her mother an overdose of morphine to get rid of her. Obviously, there's a different story here. However, my mother does deserve to know that I did love her. I just didn't know how much until she was gone. You know, sometimes I can still hear her alto voice over and over. Ellie, smile for the camera. Oh, come on, Ellie, you look so pretty when you smile. Hey, I didn't smile for my mother. Kate Goulding, the homemaker. Now, when anybody's ever called a homemaker, God, they rarely are. Oh, well, I think of my mother. I mean, she made the balanced meals, she took the cooking classes, she wallpapered every detail in every room. I mean, the picture frames matched the walls matched the picture frames, the room as well. Wallpapered. Now, I'm not telling you these things to describe my mother, but out of tribute. I mean, things like this in my mother's whole life. Like the time she came to visit me in New York City. Oh, you have no window coverings. The whole world just watches you while you change. And I said, yeah, Mom, the whole neighborhood is gay. You know, I can remember the last completely normal day of my life. I was watching a movie. It was Grace Kelly and Barry Cooper. Oh, my mom and I used to hate them. Oh, yeah, we thought they were so white bread. Well, anyway, my mother had just finished having a hysterectomy. And I figured, you know, 4 days was enough for the occasion. And then I could head back to New York City and my job as editorial director for a very large New York magazine. You know, they used to say that I, Ellie Goulding, would walk over my mother in golf spikes to succeed. Yeah, I was still my old self then. You know, smart, young, successful, self-involved. I mean, come on, I got paid to be a wise ass for a living. You know, go to parties, talk to people, make fun of them, print. It was like getting paid to breathe. And then just like that, I went from this successful wise ass to this Betty Crocker. With one word my father said. Cancer. Well, I started to walk out of the room. Ellen, you're staying. Your mother needs you. Fine. It's not like she's gonna last forever anyway, right, Dad? Low blow? Me. But I had just gone as far and as quickly as possible, and now I was back to where I began. I mean, acres and acres of farmland, a Pizza Hut, for goodness sake, and very, very bad Chinese takeout. So I picked up my bags, and I'm getting ready to go. And then my father. So, Ellen, you have a Harvard education. But you have no heart. Truth? I felt like I had to be whatever my father wanted me to be. I had to prove to him that I had heart. You know, I can remember when my mother came home from the hospital. Her shoulder blades seemed sharp, like little wings jutting out of her back. Oh, honey, you don't mind me, I'm fine. You know, I was thinking, you and I need a project together. And I was thinking a book group. You know, the Goulding Girls Book Club?
Okay, so Kate and Ellen are finally My mother became this child, and I became like a mother. Well, in one instance, the bathroom door is closed, and I go to knock. I have to go in because she can't get out of the bathtub on her own. Finally, I picked up a towel off a bench she had made. And I started to pull. And her legs just rolled helplessly in the water. I mean, she weighed nothing. Yet she felt so heavy. And the skin is stretched out in places. And the body is slapped, and there's this summer smell. You see, our dilemma is this. You look at this woman and you understand her. You know, never being anything more than a mother. A mother who wakes up every morning to take care of her home and loves every day of it no matter what. Damn it, we divide women into groups. Not this body and soul's comedy of the Madonna and the whore, but the woman of the heart and the woman of the mind. And like David and Elizabeth, I got designated the heart's Messiah. My mother, the mindless. Yeah, it was a disservice to us both, but you know, I still think she had a better end of the deal. She said, I love you. And for the first time, in a very long time, I said, I love you too, Mom. And she just smiled. Oh, I mean that smile looked like the moon just laying on its side. I took her hand and began to breathe a tan in with her. In. Out. In. Out. In.
Oh, let her intrude. You end up in Maisie, Marjorie.
The prince is giving a ball. The prince is giving a ball.
I wish I dated lanterns. I wish I were demure and sweet. I wish I were a woman. Possible.
You have no idea what it may be.
No, I have no idea. I wonder how we can find out what it is.
Let us think of our history.
It isn't very long, is it?
10 minutes ago, I saw you. I looked up when you came through the door. My head started breathing, you gave me the feeling. The room had no ceiling or floor.
John Grubb won two awards, an
honorable mention in sports opinion, and honorable mention in sports feature. Thank you, Brian, for holding that applause. Max Matheny won 2 awards, an honorable mention for personality profile, and an excellent in sports news. Christian Brady won honorable mention in news writing. Kristen Petterly won an excellent in commentary. Ryan Patterson won an excellent in sports opinion. Liz Myers won an excellent in sports news. Tony Epidino won an honorable mention news photo and superior in editorial. Katie Davis won an excellent in sports features. This last staffer I want to save towards the end because she has set a new Bruin record for most individual awards. Julianne Osbold won 4 awards, an honorable mention in personality profile, honorable mention in depth, honorable mention front page design, and honorable mention news writing. There were 2 more awards that were won by non-staffers, who were willing to submit their work to the Bruin. If they could come down, that would be wonderful. Emily Stein won an honorable mention in editorial cartoon, and Pat Brink won an excellent editorial cartoon.
Always taking a different approach to teaching, not assumed to make
straight up R&B. No band picks it up like the Tower of Power. That was a quote from the famous Ray Charles, a man who helped invent the genre. Tower of Power is known for their brassy, reedy, rich grooves and a contagious, happy, life-asserting celebration of good feeling. The horn section is played on many well-known artists, ballads like Elton John and Santana and many others to credit. Listen and enjoy the hard-hitting, funkified sounds of his next two, with soloist Patrick Lamiel and Steve Sugner. Get ready for a true soul injection with What Is Hit.
Thank you. Madison with Dear God. And first place was Abigail Legman from Picture to Silence. In the Death, Dying, and Loss category, the runner-up was Ward Greenwald with Forever Altered. And the first place was Kate Hudson, If Only.
Wow, what a great show.
Yeah, everyone did such a terrific job.